Welcome
to Many Voices.
Hello, one and all.
Welcome back to Manly Voices.
My name is Evan,
also known as Manly Ankles.
I'm back again with Gabs. Hey!
Wow, that worked better than I thought it would.
I know, I was expecting it to fall apart a lot sooner than
All right.
I was actively expecting it to fall apart.
So Gabs and I are in a mood. We're both pretty tired.
But only one of us is drinking a Baja Blast, which I think has caffeine in it.
Does it?
Lime
flavor. Taco Bell.
Caffeine content, 58 milligrams.
That sounds right.
That sounds like they're, yes.
All right.
Tested positive for caffeine.
Okay,
honey, the test results came back. It's positive.
58 milligrams. God, what have I done? So we're playing.
You ruined me.
We're playing Danganronpa, and this time we're at Gabs' apartment.
I know. There, many things are the same, and to the casual viewer of this video, everything is the same, but to us...
The landscape and the setting are
very different.
Very different.
So, we're plus two cats, but there are the same amount of cats in this vicinity
one dog, mostly.
We are plus one dog.
Okay, so we finished chapter three. Celeste killed Hifumi, who killed Taka. Which was very upsetting.
And I'm still fucking mad about it.
Yeah, when I was naming that title, the title of that episode, it's the ultimate sad Gabs.
It is. I was rewatching an older episode where, like, it was one of the class trials, and it's like, pick the killer, and Evan hovered over Taco for a minute, and I was...
Don't even joke about
this. Yeah, I said something like, that's not funny, that's my baby.
Yeah.
And that didn't happen.
And we also found out that Sakura is a spy for Monokuma.
I thought you were going to say, and we also found out that Leon killed Sayaka.
Yeah, we found her, finally.
There she is! I totally had forgotten, like, what she looked like and everything about her. Like, I've, like, put her away. I've completely compartmentalized her.
That's so funny, from how the game tries to make you feel about her.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I call you fucking bluff. Taka's the real homie, closely followed by Sakura and Hiro and Hina.
Alright. Leon killed Sayaka.
Oh, fuck! I forgot about how... I
forgot about Junko, too.
I forgot about how she died. I remembered that she was dead, but I forgot about the 1,000 knives to the whole body.
Monokuma killed Junko. Then Leon got executed.
Oh, that's the most brutal execution so far.
Then Mondo killed Chihiro. And then he got executed.
Turned into Mondo butter.
Hifumi killed Taka, then Celeste killed Hifumi. Then she got executed.
Now?
And that brings us up to now.
And that's the story of how I met your mother.
The next morning and okay, so there is an alternate ending in chapter 5 that decides kind of everything. It's like a, oops, you got the bad ending kind of thing. And I'm hoping we'll be able to see that instead of picking the right ending, you know?
So I get to pick?
Yeah, well, we'll get there. I'll let you know when we get to that point. The next morning
but
in the dining hall.
But you won't tell me which one's which, right?
I will not, yeah.
Okay.
You're gonna have to make that choice.
Watch me pick the bad ending, because I'm vindictive and bitter as fuck at this point.
The day after Celeste's case.
So now there's only 5 of us here.
Only a third of the number of people we started with.
Loneliness has become commonplace.
Here, come back so you can pick up on the mic a little more.
Commonplace. That's true.
Still.
Oh, damn.
What did I see yesterday?
I love that face.
That, yes.
That fucking White Walker, blue glowy eye, so fucking swole.
I don't understand. Sakura's the mastermind spy? Can that really be true?
Or at least she was. Who knows where we're at now?
Makoto, are you okay?
No, I'm fine.
No, I mean, I'm fine.
I can't bring it up in front of the others. If I did that, it would just confuse everyone that much more.
Oh.
What are you doing?
Okay! In that case, let's eat till we pass out.
God, that's me and fuck.
What do you mean in that case?
Well, because look how scary everyone looks. It's got to be because you're fighting on empty stomachs, right? If you fill your belly, I'll...
What exactly are we eating that makes us make those slurping sounds?
A lot of totally normal things.
Look at the way he slurps up his soup. What an asshole! What an asshole!
What? I'm sure I'll tear up, so let's eat! Let's fry up some fish and donuts and eat till we can't stand up!
That's like a deep impact style meteor impact extinction level event combination of foods.
That's kind of what I was thinking too. What? Those are both breakfast time top sellers. Still, the till we can't stand up part is a problem. After we're done, we need to go explore.
That's right. Since the class trial is over, yeah. New areas should have opened up.
I totally forgot about that.
Yeah, me too. I just thought that we were, like, coming up on the end game already.
We're pretty close.
Oh, that means Hero's gonna die. Like, Hero is next, I'm sure of it. Plus, we still have Alter Ego. We don't have to give in to despair just yet.
She's right. We have to plan ahead and think about the future.
Yeah, think happy thoughts, not deathy thoughts.
Like, when we're gonna get out of here, right? When this is all over, I think I want to get reborn for serious. I mean, reborn as someone serious.
Hey, are you okay? That sounds like something someone who's about to die would say.
I'm totally okay. I'm not gonna die. Why? Because there aren't gonna be any more murders.
Said everybody the last four times there were murders. Also, what did I just say about him being next?
Right.
What makes you so sure?
I predicted it last night. Since it revealed itself to me from the ether, there's no doubt about it.
Okay!
How accurate is your fortune telling anyway?
Gabs is putting in the pizza.
Implementing the pizza!
Which is another constant of recordings, usually.
I can usually hit 20 or 30% on a good day.
That seems really low.
Well, yeah, it's not like it's ESP or whatever. Of course I'm only gonna get it right sometimes.
That's true, he's not a fortune teller, he's just clairvoyant.
Yeah. I told you, my fortune telling isn't like some occult thing.
Fortune telling isn't a cult?
Of course not! Clairvoyance is clairvoyance. Don't put it in the same category as cattle mutilation.
Whoa!
Cattle what?
Whoa!
He's referring to the urban legend where aliens abduct cows and dissect them as part of their research.
No!
Whoop, that was weird.
No, you're calling it an urban legend? As a matter of fact, it's true. As a matter of fact, it happened to me.
You got slaughtered by a cow, or you slaughtered a cow? What?
It all happened one day when I went to go get a hamburger.
Oh my god, wait.
It's a place I'd never been before. They claimed their patties were 100% all beef.
Okay.
So I got a burger to go and headed home.
Fresh, never frozen.
And before long, the sky was filled with a mysterious blinding light. Oh my god.
I thought it was gonna be like, the sun!
Some crazy beam came out of nowhere and locked onto my hamburger.
God, that weed was skunky.
And as soon as the beam touched it, the burger started floating in midair. And then, still floating there, the entire burger started coming apart. One part of it just vanished, while the rest fell back into my hand.
I never bought from that dude in the alley ever again.
Do you realize what that means? It means the burger wasn't 100% beef. It must have had some pork or something mixed in.
That's what that means?
Something like 70% pork and 30% beef would be my guess. So I stormed back into the burger place and got up in the manager's grill, and they totally admitted it. It wasn't 100% beef. They totally mixed ground pork with it. Now do you see? That is cattle mutilation.
I kind of got lost halfway through.
Yeah, it's blunt. I can't tell if you're for the occult or against it. You stink of stupidity
and marijuana.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
I stink. How dare you?
Well, you do stink, though.
That's fine.
That's fine.
anyway, I hope your prediction turns out to be true.
Well, at the very least, I won't murder anyone.
I know you won't, you beautiful baby lamb. Me either. I mean, I would never.
Me either.
Nor I.
That goes for me too, of course. I could never kill any of my friends.
Everyone's like, who's gonna tell him?
I felt like those words of encouragement were helping us come together as one.
Is that what you felt like?
After so much sacrifice and hardship, we finally become united.
Oh, Makoto, I hope you're next.
But...
To be honest, I wish Byakuya and Toko were here for this too.
but they're so hard to deal with. They only think about themselves.
Yeah, we're better off without him, I'd say. That was enough to prove. We were united for the time being, but within that bond held weakness and fragility.
Yep.
That was a very crisp... I can't do that. I really can't.
You can't.
All-star apologies.
Oh.
That's okay. That's the combination of All-Star by Smash Mouth and All Apologies by Nirvana.
Yeah. You know, it's the mashup for the ages. It's the thing that we never knew we wanted, but was forced upon us anyway.
We began our search as soon as we'd finished our breakfast in the dining hall. We had to find out what opened up and what was waiting for us. All right, nice. Let's go explore the fourth floor.
Fourth floor.
I'm just going to go ahead and fast travel to the third floor so we don't have to, like...
do all of the... And so we don't get distracted along the way.
Yeah. Stairs to the fourth floor.
Nice.
Okay, so it should be right here. Yeah.
Nice.
Going to the fourth floor and we don't know what's in store.
It's yellow.
So now we have access to the fourth floor of Hope's Peak Academy. Maybe this time we'll find some kind of clue. No, this time I have to find it. My missing pair of socks.
Oh, no, it's just one sock that he lost on, like, day one. He's been walking around with, like, one athlete's foot this whole time.
No joke. One of the promo art photos of Makoto is him slipping and one of his shoes flying off his foot.
Oh, bless.
Because he's so...
He's such a fucking...
It's like, it's a testament to his unlucky, lucky studentness.
Yeah.
And his, ordinary thing.
Oh, no, not again.
Whoops.
It's because my feet are two different sizes.
Data lab.
That's kind of cool.
Rattle, rattle.
No good, the door's locked. I guess I won't be getting in here. According to the nameplate, it's called the data center.
That's not what it says.
Well, but what's behind the door is a total mystery. Maybe on one side it says data lab and the other side says data
center. Does it?
Let's find out.
Nope.
Makoto's just stupid.
He's like, I was trying to use context clues and they led me astray.
It's a classroom.
There's probably something creepy written on the chalkboard.
One day, I saw Monokuma in class.
Hi, Hiro.
It is it's Makoto, drawn on the chalkboard.
Aww.
One day, la 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 la, gobble. What?
Did Hiro draw this?
I'm glad this floor got opened up at all, but there's like a ton of locked rooms up here.
Great.
Sakura could just like smash her way into any of these rooms.
I think that actually comes up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Alright, it's the other classroom. Ooh. Hello, I'm Monokuma from the school store. I'm very kind. Gather up your coins and come play with me, or I might die of loneliness.
Same.
He's like, Pico. He's all shy. That's cute.
God, they did such a good job in this game of making Monokuma such a lovable, horrible character.
Right.
Like, I love him so much, but he's just the worst. He's actually the worst.
Ooh,
the
chem lab.
Chem lab. Can we go?
Woof.
Boofer!
Ooh. That's like a mad scientist lab.
Inside the room, the smell of medicine was oppressive. So this is the chem lab. I hope inhaling all this stuff doesn't do permanent damage.
Oh, buddy.
I guess there's not much to do. Let's talk to Sakura.
Yeah, Sakura, what's going on?
Sakura's lost in conversation with Hina. I need to find out what's going on with
their
Sakura
and the
mastermind.
Their relationship is gonna be ruined.
But I can't while she's with Hina.
What is it, Makoto? Did you need something?
No, it's nothing.
Really? Well, okay. Bye.
Okay,
bye.
Hina and Sakura seem to be lost in deep but friendly conversation.
Yeah, I bet it's deep but friendly.
Huh? You need something?
No, it's nothing.
You sure? Okay, then.
Alright. That's helpful.
Love that for us.
It's a remarkably big shelf, and it's stocked with all kinds of medicine.
Hey, listen, Makoto! Listen! Just take a deep breath, calm down, and listen to me!
Okay, Hina, just chill out.
There's all kinds of stuff we didn't have before. Vitamins, minerals, amino acids, creatine. And what? They even have Proteinzyme X.
What's that?
It is steroids.
She's also like gripping Makoto with iron grip.
Like crushing his bones, yeah.
You're literally breaking my bones.
Rips his arms off in her excitement.
Start beating. Arms. I like to
it's a protein drink. It is nothing like the cheap swill we had in the warehouse. It's connoisseur level.
Oh yeah?
Hey.
Can you get my arms back?
Please. Oh, her little kitty face.
Yeah.
This is amazing. It's a gold mine. My prayers have finally been answered. Time to load up on more prayers, then!
A gold mine, huh?
Alright.
Yay, that's fine.
I guess that's all we're gonna get here.
Okay, bye.
Alright, here's
the next
floor.
Just remember that Taka's not here.
Yeah, sorry.
I'm not gonna run into Taka anywhere.
Yeah. Well, there's always the bonus mode where we get to, like, date everyone. Not date, but, like, go through all their free time events.
Oh,
basically.
That's kind of nice. So we could hang out with my baby. My precious baby boy.
What fluttered to the floor?
This is the office. But of course there's no hint of any teachers that we'd normally be able to rely on.
But where are those good old homespeak teachers? On which we used to rely.
There's a picture on the floor. This picture.
Oh my gosh.
What?
That's right, it's another one of these.
Yeah, last time it was Mondo, Chihiro, and Leon.
Yeah.
Celeste, Hifumi, and Sayaka? The smiling faces of three people who are dead now. A classroom without metal plates over the windows. It's exactly the same. It's just like that picture I saw before.
Aww, I miss Mondo. Yeah.
There's no way this isn't important somehow.
Is he actually gonna keep it this time?
They're smiling the way you'd expect any normal teenager to smile. Just a normal group of high schoolers living a normal school life. I can't possibly believe they were able to smile like that in a world of despair like this.
Are you actually gonna keep it this time?
I hope so.
So does that mean this picture was taken before they ever came to Hope's Peak?
Because Monokuma snatched it last time, right?
Yeah.
Everyone in the picture knew each other before they got here? Including Sayaka?
Pick it up!
No, there's no way! Monokuma did it! It must be fake!
Pick it up!
Ugh! Yo! You're fake! Monokuma popped out of nowhere and snatched the picture from my hand. A forgery plot? What are you, a middle schooler? You think the moon landing was faked too? Come on! Then you're saying this picture is real? If there was such a thing as the Nobel Truth Prize, I'd take first, second, and fourth place!
Who gets third?
Actually, that's probably not true. I asked you a question. Is this picture real or is it a fake? Oh, Makoto, you're so eager to split things in half, aren't you? You're one to talk, Mr. Black and White.
Yeah, seriously,
creature.
Mr. Yin and Yang situation.
But it's no use. It's just no use! If you try to split something that can't be split, you'll end up feeling like you're the one being split. The picture is real. No more, no less. Without another word, Monokuma disappeared. So the picture is real? It's really real. If that's true. If that's the case.
What?
I'm not gonna finish my thought.
Yeah. I don't know any of the words that I was gonna say.
There's a flower on the desk. Somehow it makes things feel that much weirder. Nice!
Nice! I feel weird.
Got 100 Monokuma
tokens. Aw, when did we get that many? Oh, we get a lot from the trials, yeah. That's right.
There's a flower on the desk. It makes things feel weirder.
Nice! Is it gonna...
Do we get Monokuma tokens from everyone?
We might.
Let's try again.
There's
a flower
on the
desk.
Desk.
It makes things weird.
Nice!
Go for 4 for 4.
Yeah.
There's a flower on the desk. It makes weird.
Nice! I'm honestly hyped about this. Where's the last one?
It's right over here. Come on. Yeah.
There's a flower,
There's
on,
a
the
flower
desk.
On the desk. Come makes on,
it
give
weird.
It to me! Nice!
My neighbors are gonna be so confused.
Oh, totally. I hope we're not too loud for them.
No, who fucking cares? Not right. I.
Not I. Nor I.
Head monster.
Headmaster. Ooh.
That's what they... Never mind.
Played on the... What? The master of giving head.
I was gonna say headmaster.
Going?
That's what they call me in the club, but...
The nameplate says headmaster's room.
There must be something worthwhile in there.
Rattle, rattle.
Maybe there's a rattle in there. The doors... Maybe we'll have to take care of a giant baby!
Ew.
Damn it!
The only thing that's more horrifying than a baby is a giant baby.
Yeah, it's the giant floating baby head from Gravity Falls.
Yeah, or did you ever see that one insurance commercial where their cars were replaced by enormous babies?
What?
Ugh,
it's never.
The worst. It's gross. Wow. It's sort of like how a chihuahua isn't a scary dog until you imagine it the size of, like, a mastiff, and then scary-looking dog.
Just like that video of the when he's petting his dog, and it's just, like, mauling the shit out of his hand.
Yes! I love that video. He's like, petting your dog is so relaxing, and the dog's like,
man! It releases a hormone in the brain called oxytocin.
The dog's just fucking going at it.
It's amazing.
Oh my god.
All right, we're gonna check out this room, and then we'll call it.
Okay.
This is the music room. It's hardly even a classroom. It's more like an actual concert hall.
I know, that's pretty intense.
Let's talk to Kyoko.
Hi, Kyoko. You know, you haven't told me what you think yet.
When did I ever think?
To what think I do what? About the secret room in the boys' bathroom.
Yeah, funny story about that. Yeah. I kind of fucked your whole thing up there.
Well, I did find the secret room, but as soon as I started looking around, I was attacked.
Attacked? By who?
Well, they came from behind, and I didn't have any time to react, so I didn't see who it was. And when I came to, the mountains of flies and documents were all gone.
Oh, files.
I was like, were there flies in there?
Just a bunch of dead flies over in the corner.
Mountains of flies.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I know how important those were.
It's okay. I already saw what I needed to in there. And I half suspected the mastermind might come after you, which is why I sent you in there instead of myself. Yeah. You see, you are the dispensable one.
What?
When I discovered the room, the mastermind must have seen me on the surveillance camera in the hallway. They must have seen me go into the boys' bathroom and then not come out again. Still, I wanted you to go and see it. I wanted you to see how the mastermind would...
He kind of was a decoy.
What a... Shit, that is so funny.
Essentially, I wanted to find out if the mastermind actually knew about that room. But to attack you and steal everything in the room, that wasn't the most predictable reaction for the person that put a bunch of teenagers in a school and told them to murder each other. Could never have seen that coming.
Hero's like, I did. Get out of here, Hero!
He just pokes his little head up like Monokuma does, like,
That must mean that there was some unknown clue in there that could reveal the mastermind's identity.
Then you knew I was gonna get attacked?
Oh, you can handle that kind of thing, though, right? After all, you're a boy.
Just because I have a dick doesn't mean it's a sword.
Oh my god, I hated everything about that sentence.
What does she think a boy is? Fine,
she's like, these patriarchal rules have to work for me in some capacity, right?
Then let me ask you something else. Do you know about the note?
Where's Sayaka?
Where is she, damn it? I know you know.
Where is Sayaka?
The note that said you must not leave. Sayaka by herself will never be able to find her.
We shouldn't talk about that. Not here.
Kyoko stole a quick glance at the surveillance camera.
I'm looking into it. If I find out anything, I'll let you know. Is that okay?
She made it sound like she was asking, but she was clear I wouldn't have any say in the matter.
Lol, I love her.
So, now it's your turn. Let's hear your secret.
Huh?
Did you think I wouldn't notice? You're hiding something. Am I wrong?
That's...
Mr. Mowgli made an appearance.
He doesn't shoot on course, does he?
No.
Okay.
I'll watch him, though.
Okay. Probably just checking out the box.
Yeah, he's like, this is so strange. My Siamese cat is out taking a little observational
stroll.
He's gotten
so big since...
He's a thick boy. Okay, yeah, bye.
I looked at him, and he's like, no.
No!
Don't look at me, I'll die.
Yeah, seriously. He weighs like 12 pounds, I think.
Oh.
Him's a big boy. Him's dad was apparently like 17, 18 pounds. And he was primarily outdoors, so he was not fat. He was just a large man.
My old cat Striker was almost 30 pounds.
What the fuck? That is not much lighter than my dog.
He was a thick boy.
Was he fat or was he just big?
He was fat. But he was a big cat, but he was also fat.
Like, okay.
He had that big dangling tummy.
Like what Mango has.
Yeah.
Like the fupa for days.
And we find the name ironic because he was so fast at the same time. Like, one day we were playing with him, like, we, like, took the remote under and put it under the blanket of the bed. He was just like, bam, bam, bam. And and Mom was playing with him, and then he accidentally got her with his claw, and she bled for, like, a couple minutes.
Oh my gosh!
It was crazy. That's why we called him Striker, because he strikes quick.
Like a turtle.
Expect, yeah.
Have you ever seen a turtle eat? It's always, like, so slowly, and then they're like, bah! And then they just take a quick bite out of it.
Oh man, we're gonna get too wrapped up in our mini conversation, so let's hurry up and finish this
later,
conversation.
After we're done here, we'll look up videos of turtles eating. Yes. Anyway.
What's the matter? If you're worried about the camera, why not just write it down?
Well...
We're friends, right? So you should be able to trust me, right? Isn't that what you said before?
You're right, there shouldn't be any secrets between friends,
Makoto's but... Makoto's so easily manipulated by literally everyone.
There's nothing worse than expressing doubt about your friend when you don't have evidence for it.
Tell her. Put your fucking cards on the table. Put your dick sword on the table.
Here, just why don't we leave? Why don't we leave this as a cliffhanger? Be next time then, on Manly Voices.
Then maybe I shouldn't have said so emphatically what I was going to tell you to do. Anyway.
Well, we'll decide whether or not to tell Kyoko about Sakura next time on Manly Voices.
Yeah.
So thank you everybody so much for watching. If you like this video, please leave a like down below and subscribe if you want to see more. please subscribe.
Please leave a like down. They're holding me hostage.
And comment on what the voice adventures you'd like to do next. Until next time, bye everybody.
Bye.